Once, long ago in India, where there were kings called Rajas and people lived in fear of them, there was a Raja who had very big ears. Now his ears were so big that he wore a special hat to hide them. All day and every day he wore his hat so that no one would know about his ears. Of course, one or two people did know about them, but they didn't say a word to anyone else about it. They could imagine what terrible things would happen to them if the Raja ever found out that they had been gossiping about him. Now, the Raja was going to get married, and so he wanted to have his hair cut. He ordered a barber to come to the palace. And when he arrived, he sent all his servants and courtiers outside. "Now listen here, young man," he said to the barber. "In a moment, I am going to take my hat off. Then you will see that I have ears that are not small. No one in the whole country knows about my ears. If ever I hear that you have been talking about my ears, gossiping, telling tales, then I shall cut off your head. If ever I hear that anyone knows about my ears, I will cut your head off. Do you understand?" "Yes, your majesty," said the barber. "Yes, your majesty." And the Raja took off his hat. And the barber started to cut his hair. All the time he was cutting away with his scissors, he was trying not to look at the Raja's ears. But they were right there in front of him all the time, just where he was looking. So he said to himself, "I must not look at the Raja's ears. I must not look at the Raja's ears. I must not look at the Raja's ears." When he had finished, the Raja put his hat on, and sent the barber off saying, "Remember what I said, young man." "Yes, your majesty, not a word, not a word to anyone." And so off went the Raja. And that's the way it was for the rest of the day. He didn't breathe a word to anyone about it. But all the time, the barber was thinking about it. At work the next day, when he was cutting other people's hair and chatting with the customer, he was thinking about it. The customer said, "Oh, I don't suppose much happens around here, does it? Day in, day out, cutting people's hair." Straight away, the thought of the Raja's big ears leapt into his mind. "Well, sir," he said, "the other day I was cutting the Raja's hair, and you won't believe it, but you know, he's got enormous..." He stopped himself. "What am I saying?" he thought. "I'll get my head cut off." "What's he got?" said the customer. Enormous jewels on his ring," said the barber. "Phew, that was a close one," he thought to himself. At home that night, his wife was changing her earrings. And he found himself saying, "Those earrings look nice on you, my dear. Thank you, said the wife, but don't you think they look a little small? They don't look small on you, my dear, but I tell you who they would look funny on, and that's the Raja, because he's got really big ears. What am I saying? He thought. I'll get my head cut off. What's he got? What's he got? Said the wife. He's got really big earrings. Small ones would look funny on him. Phew, that was another close one, he thought. Outside, in the yard, his children were pulling faces at each other, sticking their tongues out and pulling their ears. Don't do that, said the barber. You'll look like the Raja. Why do we look like the Raja, Daddy? They asked. Because he's got big... What am I saying? I'll get my head chopped off. He's got big children, said the barber. And they look like the Raja, and you look like his children. So, you look like the Raja. Whew, phew, that was another close one. And so it went on all next day. He was dying to tell someone. In the end, he had a plan. The next morning, instead of going straight to work, he went off to the woods. I know what I'll do, he thought. I'll tell a tree that the Raja's got big ears, and that'll be that. It won't bother me anymore. I'll have told someone who can't tell anyone else. The Raja will never find out, and I'll feel a lot better. So the barber crept up to a great big tree in the woods. He looked behind the tree and all around, and then he stood next to it and shouted, "The Raja's got big ears!" Oh, that felt so much better. It felt like a great load had been taken from his back. And off he went to work, happier than he had been for days. Now the seasons passed in the woods, winter to spring, summer to monsoon, and still the tree stood still. One day in spring, a woodcutter came to the woods. And the woodcutter chopped down the tree. And the woodcutter sold the wood from the tree to a musical instrument maker. And the instrument maker made some instruments. And the instrument maker sold the instruments to a band that was the best in the country. In fact, this band was so good that it was asked to play at the Raja's wedding. And finally, the day of the wedding arrived. Everyone was there, all the Raja's relations, all his servants, and the servants of the servants, even the barber. What a day it was. There was a wonderful ceremony. There was a wonderful ceremony.
I know.
After the ceremony, there was a fantastic feast. And then a wonderful, spectacular, amazing, beautiful cultural program. It was time for the musicians to play. There was a hush, and the music began, but of all surprising and awful things to happen, the sound coming out of the musical instruments wasn't a wedding dance, but a song. And the words of the song were... shouted the Raja. I heard that, he roared. I heard every word of that. The hundreds of wedding guests stood still in silence. The thought of his barber sprang to his mind. Only the barber knew about his ears, and only the barber could have told anyone. Barber! Bellowed the Raja. The barber stepped forward. Yes, Your Majesty, yes, Your Majesty. I heard that song. You heard that song. You have disobeyed me. I told you not to tell a single person about my big ears, and now everyone knows. But, Your Majesty, I didn't tell a single person. Oh, yes, you did, and tonight you lose your head. But Your Majesty, I didn't tell a single person. I told a tree, and that's not a person, is it? The Raja stopped. A smile crept on his face. He muttered to himself, I didn't tell a person. I told a tree. The man's right. He didn't tell a single person. Oh, why am I making such a fuss? It's only ears. So what if I have big ears? Some people have big feet. Some people have little noses. We're all different, and we always will be. And at that, he pulled off his hat and said, friends, relations, the Raja's got big ears. Let the band play. Oh.